And there's more fallout tonight as the fate of horse racing in Maryland remains unclear. The Preakness and some 10,000 jobs all are in jeopardy after the Maryland Racing Commission rejected a proposal that would drastically reduce live racing. 11 News reporter Kai Reed caught up with a key player in all this, and she joins us now from Pimlico tonight with more. Kai.
Well, Marianne, the track owners have yet to make any kind of public comment since the commission's decision last night, but state officials and some in the racing industry are hoping that something can be done to salvage the schedule for next year.
With next year's racing schedule in limbo, the question tonight is what's next? Track owners have until December 21st to come up with a plan that the Maryland Racing Commission will accept. Last night, the commission rejected the proposal that would have given Penn National 49% interest in the Maryland Jockey Club and reduced racing to just 47 days next year. 17 days at Laurel and 30 days around the Preakness. Reps from the Jockey Club and Penn National have not commented on the commission's rejection.
The council did the only thing it could do.
But tonight, developer David Cordish, who plans to put a $320 million slots facility at Arundel Mills Mall, said the commission members did the right thing.
The commission was absolutely correct. It's ridiculous to think that you're going to subsidize this industry to the tune of $100 million and not going to run but a couple races.
Many people in the horse racing industry agree. Horse breeder Mike Pond says the track owner's proposal showed a lack of commitment to the racing industry and the thousands of jobs it provides.
Well, it's very frustrating. You know, my livelihood's based on 140-some racing days, and that's what we've had here forever.
Besides track owners coming up with a new plan the commission would approve, there is the option of the state exercising eminent domain and taking over the tracks.
And that's what should happen, and then put it in the hands of people that are competent. And I wouldn't be surprised if that isn't what happens.
Now, representatives from Penn National and the Jockey Club are expected to make a statement about the commission's decision tomorrow. The current racing schedule is scheduled to end on December 18th. Reporting live at Pimlico, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.